Hello children, welcome to the social science class of 8th standard. Today you will learn a new branch. The branch is business studies. The first chapter is components of business study. In this chapter we shall learn about the basic aspects of business studies, that is economic activities and its types, the different stages involved in the evolution of business, the role of trade and commerce in economic development, development of commerce during 21st century. Now let us understand about the word business. The term business is derived from the word busy. Thus, businessman mean being busy. Look at the picture below, where a businessman is involved in numerous activities like checking mails, every aspect of business. We have learnt about the word meaning business. Now let us understand about the basic aspects of business studies and the economic activity which form the basis for all the business activities. Look at the picture, children, where you are seeing food, clothing, shelter and many more things which we need for satisfying our daily life needs. So where do we get these goods? We get from the shopkeeper. And where does the shopkeeper get? He gets from the wholesaler. And where does the wholesaler get things? He gets things from the manufacturer. So what are these shopkeeper, retailer and manufacturer involved? They are involved in doing business. So they are called businessmen. So you can look at the picture where there is a consumer, retailer and wholesaler and manufacturer. Consumer means who are purchasing goods. Retailer means shopkeeper, and shopkeeper get things from the wholesaler, and wholesaler get things from the manufacturer. So retailer, wholesaler and manufacturers are doing business. What is business? Business is an economic activity which is related with continuous and regular production and distribution of goods and services for satisfying human wants. Look at the picture, children, where an industry is shown, where they are producing numerous goods. Let us take an example of Oreo biscuit. It is an Oreo biscuit factory. They are continuously producing. After producing, those produced biscuit has to be distributed. You can see there is a small manufacture sector where they are distributing. Blue arrow marks, you can see from there various distribute agencies will make the product available to the consumer. So the consumer get the Oreo biscuits through distribution. So like this, where they produce the goods continuously and regularly, produce the goods and distribute of goods and services for the satisfaction of human wants is called as a business. Human wants are unlimited. How can we satisfy these unlimited wants? Through various goods and services. Where do we get goods? From agriculture and industry. And various services we get from the service agencies. So these goods and services are to be distributed among us. How? Through economic activities. What are economic activities? The activities which are mainly concerned with production and exchange of goods and services are called economic activities. You can look at the picture where production takes place and that reaches to the consumer. This is the process of exchange. Okay, that is what is called as economic activity. We have understood what is economic activities. Now let us understand about the types of economic activities. The economic activities can be broadly classified into three types, that is business, profession and employment. The types of economic activity, the first one is business. Business, it is mainly concerned with production and exchange of goods and services. Let us take an example where they produce a laptops and those laptops has to reach to the consumers. And consumer purchases those laptops and the money it has to reach to the producer. This is what is business. Now let us understand the second type of economic activities, that is profession. What is profession? It is mainly concerned with rendering of specialized technical and personal services. What is rendering means? Providing, giving. So let us take an example of a doctor. Can anybody become a doctor and start treating the patient? It is not possible. The person who is called as a doctor has to finish his MBBS course. He has to learn what are the medicines to be prescribed for which kind of diseases, and he has to get trained by the senior doctors. After he trains, he can open his clinic and he can treat. This technical skill he has to acquire. Same way, an accountant, he has to get the knowledge of accounting from the college and or various courses. Then he has to get trained. Then he will make a credit and debit and the balance sheet. So that will, he has to acquire that knowledge. Even a nurse, teacher, they have to acquire certain skills. And those skills has to be utilized to provide services for the consumers. So professionals are the people who have certain specialized. Specialized means only that particular skill can be done by the person who has acquired that knowledge, and technical services that can be provided services for the people. You understood what is profession? Profession, it is mainly concerned with providing, giving specialized techniques and professional activities. It may be the professional cook, driver, veterinary doctor, opticians, and many more professionalists. Now let us understand the third type of economic activities, that is employment. It is the work undertaken by the people under an employer for salary or wages. In the picture you can see an agricultural labor, and second picture shows the industrial labor. Who is employer? Employer is the owner who appoints people to work under them. Who is employees? The people are workers or called as employees. They are appointed by the employers. So what is employment? It is a work undertaken by the people under an employer for salary. Now let us understand about the exchange. What is exchange? The distribution of goods and services is called exchange. So exchange is acting like a link. Link means it is joining between production and consumption. The goods produced at a place has to be reaching different places where the consumers are there. Is it not? Let us take an example of how they make a bread in bakery and how they distribute in the shops. So for making bread, they need wheat that comes from the farmer, and the wheat flour that comes from the mill goes to the bakery. They bake the bread, and after the bread is baked, it is distributed to the various shops. And the shopkeeper sells those breads to the consumer. Where the distribution takes place, where the produced goods reaches to the consumer, that is called as a exchange. The distribution of goods and services is called as a exchange. Is it very clear? This exchange is a connecting or a link between producer and a consumer. In factory goods are produced and it has to reach to the consumer through various distributors. Understood? So during the production, the producer has to take consideration of many things like market study, transportation, storage of goods, and determination of price, advertisement. Look at the picture where they are looking at the charts of how much their product is sold, which market their product is sold more, which market their product is not sold. They have to study about the market. And transport, which method they have to transport the goods to the various area. It is through airways, railways, roadways, or waterways. Is the international market they are supplying, or to the local market, which market they are supplying the goods. Based on that, they have to select the transport. Yeah. Now let us understand about the storage. See, when goods are produced, it is not sold in one day. They have to store the products that is produced very carefully. So there should be a storage house. So certain vegetables and fruits cannot be sold. They have to be stored in a cold storage. What is cold storage? A huge place is converted into the refrigerator condition, and they store the vegetables, fruits, and even the variety of goods which won't spoil has to be taken carefully that those goods are not damaged. It has to be stored. That is the storage facility also the producer has to take into. And price determination. What price they have to determine for the goods produced? How much the cost is involved in producing? What is their profit they are expecting? What is the competition price in the product? You have many varieties of soap. Those soaps are like competition. What price they will determine? And what price the consumer is willing to purchase? That also play a very important role. And price determination. While determining the price, all these aspects has to be taken into consideration. Next is advertisement. Till we get the knowledge about a product, nobody will sell. Nobody will sell, nobody will purchase. So how this knowledge about the product is given? Through advertisement. Advertisement is done through magazine, billboards, newspaper, printing, radio, television, internet. Is it not? We know about Lux soap because we have seen advertisement. Have you seen any advertisement about Dodo soap? No, we haven't seen because we haven't listened any advertisement. Is it not? So we have understood that how the producer takes various aspects while producing goods and fixing the price, all those things. Now to exchange, we have money. Money is a medium of exchange. Through money, we exchange goods and services. So for example, if you go to the shop, you take a pencil. When you take pencil, in return you pay the money. So money is a medium of exchange. If you go to any music class, you attend the music class. For that you pay the fees. That is a service fees. Is it not? So exchange is the system that becomes a foundation for the business. Is it very clear, children? So today what we have learned? We have learned about the word meaning business and economic activities, types of economic activities and exchange.